Hello and welcome to a Unraid Quickie on how to swap your Parity drive. In this video, I will go through four different procedures. Each procedure has its own pros and cons. Single, dual, single swap takes a long time but keeps the Parity protection throughout the whole procedure while also causing minimal downtime. Offline swap keeps the Parity protection throughout the procedure but requires the array to be shut down. Parity to data drive swap is a more complicated procedure in which you want to replace a failing drive with a new drive that is bigger than the parity. It involves taking the current parity as a new data drive and adding the new drive as a parity. Yolo swapping is one of the easiest methods that also keeps the array online but removes the parity protection till the process is done. Here are the timestamps for the different procedures so you can skip to the part that is of interest to you. Single, dual, single swap. For the single, dual, single swap procedure, we have the following situation. We have one working parity drive, we have a few data drives, and then we have one new bigger drive that I want to replace my parity with. We now add this new drive as a second parity and start our array. Once the array is started, a rebuild process will start and the parity 2 will be synced. Once the synchronization has finished, we can stop our array again. Now we just have to remove our original parity drive, click on yes, I want to do this, and then start the array. With that, we now have our array up and running with the new parity drive. As we had our original parity drive available during the building of parity 2, it provided parity protection until the process was finished and parity 2 was ready to take over. The offline swap presents us with the same situation as the single dual single swap. We have one working parity drive, we have a few data drives, and then we have one new bigger drive that I want to replace my parity with. This time, I immediately replace the parity drive with the new drive, and then start the array in maintenance mode. This mode will not mount the array, and as such the disks will not be available during the rebuild. By clicking Sync, we start the parity rebuild. Once the rebuild is done, we can stop the array and then restart it without maintenance mode. As the array was not modified during the rebuild, the old parity never lost its validity. If a drive failed during the rebuild, we could just replace the new parity with the old one and mark it as valid. Parity to data drive swap. The parity to data drive swap presents us with a slightly different situation. We have one working parity drive, we have a few data drives, but one of these data drives has either failed or is showing signs of failing soon. In this case, let's assume disk 3 is about to die, and we have a new replacement drive that is bigger than the parity. Because the replacement is bigger than the parity, we can't directly add it as a replacement. So, we will first just remove the failing data drive. Then start the array and stop it right after. Now we remove the old parity drive and put it in the failed disk's location. And put the new bigger drive as a new parity. We can now see a copy selection. We can check the yes, I want to do this, and click on copy. The array will now copy the data from the old parity drive to the new parity. During this process, we cannot access the drives. Once the copy has finished, the array will be automatically stopped. We can now start the array up again. The rebuild of the disk 3 is now starting. During this process, we can already access our data again. Once the rebuild is complete, we have finished the procedure. Yolo Swap. The Yolo Swap presents us with the same scenario as the offline or dual parity swap. We have one working parity drive, we have a few data drives, and then we have one new, bigger drive that I want to replace my parity with. This time, I immediately replace the parity drive with the new drive and start the array normally. This will start the parity rebuild, and the disks are available immediately. During the rebuild, we will not have any parity protection. Because of that, I do not recommend using this procedure. Once the rebuild is complete, we have finished the procedure. I hope you were able to find a procedure that works best for your specific situation. I personally recommend procedure A for most cases. In a direct disk fail with a bigger replacement drive, C is the way to go. Anyways, have a nice day and see you in the next video.